Today on How It's Made.
We're breaking down Surrounded by Nobody from my Coronapocalypse EP. I thought it would be fun if this week I broke down all of the songs from the EP. And I'll have the link in the description for the whole EP if you want to listen to it. This is a pretty short song because it's sort of like an intro. So in the intro, I have a recording of me playing piano, which I recorded actually on my phone with the Voice Memos app. So that sort of gave it like a lo-fi sound. And then I added some reverb and an Isotope vinyl, which added sort of the detuned sound and just generally made it sound a little less high fidelity. So here's what that ended up sounding like. So that's all there is in the intro, and then right before it drops, I have a little clip from the last chord, which I used and sort of faded up to make kind of a riser. And then that same riser repeats two times during the drop. So the drop is actually surprisingly simple. There's the chords, and then I just have some simple drums and an 808. So the 808 is simple. I added some saturation to make it a little stronger. I have a basic kick. And then I have a cool snare that I made, and I actually put together two different snares and panned them to the right and left. So one of them hits before the other one. And so it ended up giving me this sort of layered effect, which sounded cool. So then for the main synth, it's actually surprisingly simple. I used my Microbrute Red and I made like an ARP with it. And then I drenched it in reverb and a bunch of effects, which made it sound like more of a chord than an ARP. I pitched it way up, which meant that it had to get warped, and I used the Beats warp mode. It focuses on the transients, and whenever it needs to fill in a space, it just goes silent. And since it isn't a rhythmic sound at all, it just has some random off-the-grid transients that it found. Using those, it gave me the sort of swing that I was looking for because almost all of them are completely off the grid. Then I have some basic, just sort of like movement effects. And I have a tom which hits on every loop. In the second half of the drop, I add a lot more percussion. And all of them swing a lot, which was what I was looking for because it just helped achieve the sort of groove I was looking for. So here's what those sound like together. Then I once again recorded me playing the Glockenspiel thingy. And they have a saturator and reverb on them just to make them a little more punchy. Also in the second half, I have another set of the same chords that are an octave down, or maybe two octaves down. They're lower and they have tons more effects on them. Then for the third part, where I'm rapping, I add sort of a chant sound, which is pitched way down so it doesn't really sound that much like people anymore. That section has the exact same drums and percussion as the drop, which tied it all together. Also in that section, I recorded a bunch of takes of me clapping, which I panned around and just sort of gave effects to give them more depth. Then obviously I have my vocals. They have some simple compression, reverb, EQ just to make them fit into the mix better. And then at the end, it's the same chant, which just sort of ended the track well. Pretty simple.
That's pretty much it. Thanks so much for watching. Like the video if you liked it. Subscribe if you want more. And I'll have the link in the description so you can listen to it. I'm definitely going to do this with the rest of the songs in the EP, so stay tuned for more, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace!